I suppose you could call me a bit of an auction whore. I go around as always looking for oddities. That's where I suppose I get this reputation for being slightly eccentric. The house is full of unusual items. I think there's quite a few bits that Drew will find of interest here. Whether he'll buy them or not, it's another matter. It depends how deep his pocket is.
So, wow, look at all this stuff. So
where'd you start?
I don't know where you start. This, I am a massive Zeppelin fan.
I'm pleased to hear that.
I love them.
Very collectible.
Can't believe you've got that.
You can buy one piece out of that from me, but I am going to charge you a lot of money for it. And it comes off that book.
Oh, my God! Are you kidding me?
I can't see from here. What's that?
The tickets from Nedworth.
Unused.
Unused tickets from... You're joking.
Wow. I'm not
oh
joking.
Oh, my God! He goes, you can buy one of those. And that's the difference here. It's being given the opportunity to buy something. If somebody ever gives the opportunity to buy something that rare, just buy it. What does one ticket from that, from one unused Led Zeppelin ticket worth?
To you?
Yeah.
I'd let you have it for 70 quid, but that would be a giveaway.
Sold. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
One ticket.
One ticket.
One ticket.
Feels like sacrilege, doesn't it?
I've never seen you so happy to buy a ticket for a gig that you can never go to. What was your first one that got you started into all this? What was your...
The start was... Yeah, that's an easy one to answer. Is, do you remember Q magazine?
Yeah, yeah.
I used to put a little lineage ad in the back saying, I will pay you £1 for each concert ticket you send. Well, this is a long time ago. This is 40 years, maybe. So people used to send me bags of tickets. This is before people started collecting tickets. Wow. And some of the tickets I bought then for a pound are now worth hundreds of pounds.
I mean, this isn't an office. This is like heaven. It's like rock and roll heaven. It's unbelievable. He loves all of this stuff. You can see he's passionate about it, and that just makes it so interesting. What does that say? Ho ho Lemmy. What's that? Two? And that's Lemmy, I'm presuming, across
yeah.
there.
Filthy
animal Taylor. Can I take it out?
Yeah, of course you can.
I'm gonna put it on top of that. It's got some great track. I love Motorhead. Anybody who knows me know I'm a huge music fan, and Led Zeppelin are one of my favourites, along with The Who. But I always remember Ace of Spades, Motorhead, as a kid. What a tune. There's an album at the back there. It's their first album. It's signed by Lemmy and Filthy Animal Taylor, the drummer, as well. So that's got to be worth some money as well.
If you didn't know, Motorhead are an extremely successful heavy metal band. Formed in 1975, they produced 22 albums over the course of 50 years, but this was their first. The artwork features a creation called Snaggletooth, which featured on most of their album artwork. Founding member, singer-songwriter and bassist Lemmy enjoyed a rock and roll lifestyle right up to his end. He died in 2015 and was widely regarded as a music legend. This signed copy by band members Lemmy and drummer Filthy Animal Taylor could be worth around £400.
What's something like that worth to you?
To you?
I'm dealing with a pro here.
Yeah. I don't know. Let's come back to that at the end of
okay.
the day.
Okay, all right. Can't quite decide on a price for that yet. I think we're going to come back to it.
There are plenty of rooms packed with collectibles, and Peter is open to offers on almost all of it.
Another amazing room.
So where would you like to start, I suppose?
Don't worry, you've got some proper... That's a 19th century Gothic folio stand you've got there as well.
Yes.
Very nice. We're going to have to look at this lot.
Oh, here he is.
Behind it, yes, look at that. And Motorhead.
Yes.
Oh.
Do you want to pull that out and put it on the floor?
Yeah. The Motorhead poster's out here. It's a French tour. It's in exceptional condition. The poster's almost perfect. No rips, no tears, no watermarks that I can see.
This is another piece of highly collectible Motorhead memorabilia. The French 1983 tour was to promote the sixth album, Another Perfect Day. The tour lineup included new guitarist Brian Robertson, who had previously played with Thin Lizzy. It could be worth around £200.
You want that and the autograph one, don't you?
Yeah.
So what are you going to bid me on those? You tell me what it's worth to you, and I'll tell you whether I'm not looking.
I don't know. I'm guessing. Is it 150?
I tell you what, I'll let you have them both for 400.
I think I was gonna sort of go in at 300. I know. I am that cheeky.
370. That's a good deal.
Sold. Can we try and put a deal together with buying the album, signed album, and that? And we end up, I think, eventually at £370. And that sounds about right to me. That's fine. I think there's... If I was going to sell them, there's a profit to be made. The chances of me selling them are pretty much zero.
I think there's something down here, being the punk that you are, or later...
Nicely worded.
In the nicest possible way. The
nicest possible way, yeah.
That might particularly fancy.
Ah.
Signed by Jamie Reid.
Jamie Reid is responsible for most of, if not one of the most iconic periods of English music LP artwork. Very, very collectible.
English artist and anarchist Jamie Reid is probably best known for his work depicting the Queen with a safety pin through her lips and swastikas for eyes. Often provocative and controversial, much of his artwork was too rude to be hung publicly. Yet he's still grown a devoted fan base of collectors who are keen to find something a bit racier than the average picture you'd hang on your wall. This signed piece could be worth around £600.
So, do you know the history of it?
No, no. I do know what it cost me and I do know what I sent it to you for.
Go on, then.
£350. I can't go lower than that. Pardon I'm definitely, it. Definitely no lower than that. Honestly, that's Drew, that's it. That that's really it. Is it. I wouldn't say it's
because it doesn't fit in with your collection.
No, it's not me.
No.
But it fits in with you, and that's why it's £350.
Okay. Can you hold that for a second?
His business partner's going to get involved as well.
Really?
He's going to sort you out.
So, £350?
Yeah, £350.
Did you buy that?
I couldn't see. Just bought it.
Have you?
I just bought it.
Oh, you're all right on that. I think you're fine
great.
On that.
That's great. Yeah, yeah. The price, £350, I think that's fine. I don't need to check at that sort of price. I'm fairly sure the name will carry it through. It's one of 200, but it's an early-ish one in the run. And it's signed. And that's the really important thing. It's signed. That adds pretty much nearly all of the value to that thing. Well, I like your library steps.
Yeah, we can do something on those.
Oh, were they free for sale?
Yeah.
The Victorians were great readers of the novel, and there was a certain cachet attached to a well-stocked library. Probably French in origin, this set of library steps are pine and unusual enough to attract attention. They are over 100 years old, but still in working order, which is testament to the quality of workmanship. They could be worth around £800.
What can I get for that? £400.
You'd be stealing it at 400.
I know, but we have to start somewhere.
I've enjoyed today, Drew.
Oh, God almighty.
But I have to say, I've enjoyed it. We'll go 500, we'll do a deal.
Sure?
Yeah.
We'll have a deal at £500. That's fine.
And you've done well.
That's right. That's all right. That's
you've
okay.
done it.
It's okay. We end up paying 500 for them, which is all of the money, because I think it's worth £800, and we need to do a little bit of work. So that I couldn't pay any more for it, but there is a profit there. Right.
Good.
Let's get the van. What a day. I have had a fantastic day. His enthusiasm, his collection, his knowledge is just wonderful. And I'm an extremely lucky boy to be able to get access to places like this and people like him.
It's been a great day. And I say that in total sincerity. I could have spent hours going through stuff with Drew, especially on the music memorabilia, which for me was, you know, absolutely fantastic. So I've had a wonderful day, and I hope he has too.
There's not many times in your life you'll see a collection like that. That was, you know, without a shadow of a doubt, the best rock and roll memorabilia collection I've ever seen.